Hello students, welcome to Renu's Englishpedia. Today we are going to do all the MCQs from the chapter The Last Lesson in the book Flamingo. The first question is, who is the author of The Last Lesson? The options are Anees Jung, William Douglas, Alphonse Doré or Selma Lagerlöf. And the right answer is Alphonse Doré. The next question is, Alphonse Doré was from which country? The options are India, France, England or New Zealand. And the right answer is France. The next question is, what made France and the people realize about the preciousness of their mother tongue? The options are A. Edict from Berlin, B. Monsieur Hamel's dress and words, C. School orders and D. School principal. And the right answer is A. Edict from Berlin. The fourth question is, the story The Last Lesson highlights which human tendency? And the options are A. Male chauvinism, B. Courage, C. Cowardice and D. Procrastination. And the right answer is D. Procrastination. The next question is, what things were taken for granted by the people of Alsace? And the options are A. The scenery outside, B. Monsieur Hamel, C. Time and school, D. Money and power. And the right answer is C. Time and school. The sixth question is, what does the last lesson symbolize? And the options are A. Loss, B. Loss of freedom, C. Loss of language, D. Loss of language and freedom. And the right answer is D. Loss of language and freedom. The seventh question is, what bad news would come from the bulletin board? And the options are A. Loss battles, B. The draft, C. Orders of commanding officers and D. All three. And the right option is D. All three. The eighth question is, what do the marching soldiers under the windows represent? And the options are A. The dawn of Prussia or the defeat of the French people, B. The defeat of Prussia, C. The victory of French and D. None of these. And the right option is A. The dawn of Prussia or the defeat of the French people. The next question is, from where did the orders come to teach only German in the districts of Alsace and Lorraine? And the options are A. France, B. Lorraine, C. Prussia, D. Berlin. And the right option is D. Berlin. The tenth question is, why was France surprised by Monsieur Hamel's attitude? Was it because Monsieur Hamel was option A, soft and kind, B option, rude, C, firm and strict, or D, all of these? And the right option is A. He was surprised by Monsieur Hamel's attitude as he was being soft and kind. The 11th question is, what was the main reason for France's reluctance to go to school? And the options are option A. He wanted to enjoy the warm sunlight. Option B. He wanted to enjoy the drilling of the soldiers. Option C. He wanted to enjoy the outdoors. And the D option is, he had not prepared the lesson of French participles. And the right answer is D. He had not prepared the lesson of French participles. Although all the options are correct, but the most appropriate one is the D option. The next question is, what did France find on reaching the school? And the options are A. People were rejoicing. B. Strange people were there. C. There was patrolling by the soldiers. And D. There was a strange quietness. And the right option is D. There was a strange quietness. The 13th question is, who occupied the back benches in the classroom? And the options are option A, village elders, option B, teachers, option C, monitors of the class, and option D, naughty students. And the right answer is option A, the village elders. The 14th question is, why was France feeling regretful and sad? And your options are option A, for reaching late, option B, for not doing his homework, option C, for change of the government, and option D, for not learning French, that was his mother tongue. And the right answer is option D, that is not learning French, which was his mother tongue. The next question is, whom did Monsieur Hamel blame for the casual attitude of everyone towards the French language? And your options are option A, parents, option B, children, option C, himself, and the D option is all the above. And the right answer is the D option, all the above. Monsieur Hamel believed that all of them were to be blamed for the state of affairs in Alsace and Lorraine. Your next question is, according to Monsieur Hamel, who was to blame for not sending the students to school? And your options are option A, the students themselves, option B, Monsieur Hamel himself, option C, the parents, or D, all of the above. And the right option is option C. It were the parents who were to blame. You need to understand the difference between the 15th question and the 16th question. In the 15th question, they are stating the fact that the entire state of the people of Alsace and Lorraine being uneducated, for that state of affairs, everyone was responsible. But for the condition that the students were not being sent to school, it were the parents who preferred that the children work at mills and factories. Your 17th question is, what did Hauser bring? And your options are option A, chocolates, option B, his old primer, option C, the children, or option D, sweets. And the right answer is option B, his old primer. Primer means an old textbook. The 18th question is, what made France forget Monsieur Hamel's ruler and crankiness? And the options are option A, patrolling of the police, option B, a strange quietness, option C, the bustle on the streets, or option D, the idea of Monsieur Hamel's leaving. And the correct answer is option D. The idea of Monsieur Hamel's leaving made France forget all about the strictness of Monsieur Hamel. Your next question is, for how many years did Monsieur Hamel serve the school? And your options are option A, 20 years, option B, 30 years, option C, 35 years, or option D, 40 years. And the right answer is option D, that is 40 years. The next question is, where did the parents send their children? And your options are, option A, school, option B, coaching classes, option C, farms and mills, and option D, movies. And the right option is option C, farms and mills. The 21st question is, why did the parents send their children to the farms and mills? And your options are option A, to play, option B, to meet friends, option C, to earn money, and option D, to meet relatives. And the right answer is option C, to earn money. The next question is, why did the villagers come to meet Monsieur Hamel in the school? And your options are option A, to show their gratitude, option B, to complain, option C, to say goodbye, or option D, to gossip. And the right answer is option A, to show their gratitude. The 23rd question is, why did Monsieur Hamel call the French language the most beautiful? And your options are option A, as it was the clearest and the most logical language, option B, as it was his native language, option C, as everyone was from France, or option D, none of these. And your right answer is option A, as it was the clearest and the most logical language. The 24th question is, what was France expected to be prepared for at school that day? And your options are option A, song, option B, dance, option C, essay writing, or option D, participles. And the right answer is option D, participles. The 25th question is quite important. The question is, according to Monsieur Hamel, when people are enslaved, which key is the key to their prison? And your options are option A, their behavior, option B, power, option C, aggressiveness, or option D, their mother tongue. And the right option is option D, their mother tongue. The 26th question is, what does the expression "the thunderclap" in the lesson mean? And your options are option A, loud but unclear, option B, loud and clear, option C, startling and unexpected, option D, unpleasant. And the right option is option C, startling and unexpected. In the next few questions, you will have to state whether the statements are true or false. And the first statement is, France was at war with Germany. And the answer is false. France was at war with Prussia, not Germany. The next statement is, France won the war. And the right option is false. France lost the war. The next statement is, the edict was a thunderclap for France. And the right answer is true. The next statement is, the people of Alsace were procrastinators. Procrastinators means people who put off their work. And the right answer is true. They were procrastinators. The next statement is, Monsieur Hamel would send the children on errands. And the right answer is true. The next statement is, Monsieur Hamel would not declare a holiday even if he wanted to go fishing. And the right answer is false. He declared a holiday whenever he wanted to go for fishing. The next statement is, according to Monsieur Hamel, French was not the most logical and clearest language. And the right answer is false. He did consider it to be the most logical and clearest language. This is again a very important statement. Prussia never tried to dominate through linguistic chauvinism. And the right answer is false. Prussia did try to dominate through linguistic chauvinism. Again, the next statement is, according to Monsieur Hamel, the only way to escape the prison of linguistic chauvinism was to stay true to your language. And the right answer is true. The next question is an MCQ. You have to fill in the blank. According to Monsieur Hamel, Dash were to blame for the lack of learning of French language. And your options are option A, France, option B, villages, option C, Monsieur Hamel, or option D, all of the above. And the right answer is option D, all of the above. The next fill in the blank is, France could now understand the rules of participles because option A, it was the last lesson, option B, Monsieur Hamel taught with patience, option C, France paid complete attention, or option D, Monsieur Hamel taught patiently and France listened with complete attention. And the right answer is option D. Your next fill in the blank is, France dreaded going to school because option A, he was late, option B, he had not done his homework, option C, Monsieur Hamel was strict, or option D, all the above. And the right answer is option D. The next fill in the blank is, the villagers were present in the classroom too. Option A, to pay tribute to Monsieur Hamel. Option B, to learn as much French as they could. Option C, to show their patriotism towards their country. Or option D, all of the above. And the right answer is option D, all of the above. The last fill in the blank is, Monsieur Hamel ended his last lesson with the words, option A, Alsace, Lorraine, Alsace, option B, Vive la France, option C, do not procrastinate, or option D, hold fast to your language. And the right answer is option B, Vive la France. With this, I end this segment of MCQs. Please stay tuned for more MCQs on the other chapters. If you like the video, please do not forget to like, share, and subscribe to Renu's Englishpedia. Thank you.